Coppinger's gonna take it right foot to Coppinger! Doncaster Rovers have done it!
Hello there, ladies and gentlemen, Aaron Chan here for Forever Football DRFC, your Doncaster Rovers fan channel, and welcome to this very special transfer analysis where we've just announced a brand new signing. Of course, the 22-year-old centre-back Ollie Younger has joined on an 18-month deal from Sunderland. Now, we're going to talk a bit in detail about this transfer, as well as club statements, media statements, and my thoughts. And it's good to speak in detail about this particular transfer because I think there's a lot of one side but the other side to this deal. So please like, comment, subscribe, click the notification bell, see them in this YouTube video, and let's get into this one. So let's speak first of all about the club statement, and the statement reads as follows. Rovers can confirm the signing of centre half Ollie Younger on an 18-month deal. The highly rated 22-year-old puts pen to paper with Rovers on Wednesday afternoon and joins from fellow Sky Bet League One side Sunderland. He came through the ranks at Premier League side Burnley and was named on the bench by Sean Dyche back in 2018. He then spent time on loan at St Patrick's Athletic before joining up with Sunderland in September 2020. The defender is impressed in the North East in both cup competitions and league games and signed improved terms at the start of the 21-22 campaign, but has since found regular game time hard to come by at the Stadium of Light. Younger makes a switch in South Yorkshire and could make his Rovers debut against MK Dons on Saturday. Now, the Free Press added to this with the player's own personal comments and a few extra details. So, of course, this is a permanent deal. Few people were like, is it a loan? Is it a permanent deal? But the rumour at the start was an 18-month contract last night. And he's in line to make his debut on Saturday. Now, Ollie Younger has said, I'm delighted to be here. It was a massive opportunity for me that I could not turn down. I want to be playing in this, the perfect opportunity for me to be around a first team environment and get some games under my belt. I have experience of playing at Wembley where there were big expectations, so there is the opportunities that have really provided me with hunger. Now, he's a Skipton-born player, and obviously initially linking up with those Sunderland under-23s. Now, in terms of Gary McSheffrey's comments, he said the deal for Younger reminds him when Joe Wright joined the club as a young defender packed with potential. He said it was really important that we got a defender in. When Ollie's name was put to us, we saw it as a good opportunity for the club. He's got a really good pedigree. He's young and hungry, which is the type of player we want here. He'll be a good asset for the club, and we feel he can be important to us in the short and long term. He's been determined to add to those defensive ranks following the injury to skipper Tom Anderson, who's out for an indefinite period due to a plantar fascia issue in his foot. So Ollie Younger is a Rover. Now, a Sunderland journalist has been giving his thoughts to Liam Hoden via the Free Press on the transfer. Now, the first question was, how has his time at Stadium of Light played out? And the answer was simple. They signed him 18 months ago. And after being released by Burnley, the under-23s had just had a really bad season and they finished towards the bottom of their league. He was brought in with a dual focus to help him to improve that team and also then to try and stake a claim in the Papa John's trophy and push his way through. He did pretty well in the Papa John's and he made his league debut in the second half of the season against Rochdale back in March and did well. They gave him a new contract last summer on improved terms because they were impressed with his impact. This season has been pretty similar with him doing well in the cup games, but he's never quite kicked on. I don't think they were necessarily looking to move him on, but he's 22 now, and although they would like to have been quite happy to keep him to have the strength in the squad and there'd be an option to cover, I think realistically at this stage he needs to be playing a lot more regularly. So how would you describe him as a player? Now, this is what Sunderland have said, or one of the Sunderland journalists have said. I'd say from what he's seen, he's quite old-fashioned and what you call as a proper centre-half. He's good in the air, likes a tackle, and he's sharp enough. He plays at right-back for Sunderland, but that was more due to injuries, and I would definitely say he's quite an unorthodox centre-half. I think he'll have a good career. We've not seen enough from him in the league to know exactly what level he's at, but since he's arrived, he's made a good impression. Now, do you think he'll come with more first-team opportunities? He said he's not really put a foot wrong when he's been called upon, especially in the Cups. I think with Sunderland in the pressure of a promotion spot, it's hard to give regular opportunities to someone who is ultimately untested. He's looked the part and I've no doubts he'll play a lot of Football League games and have a good career. Looking forward, I think he could develop pretty quickly over the next few years. So that is what a Sunderland journalist told Liam Hoden via the Free Press. Now, obviously, you guys want to know my thoughts on this. And I think this deal strikes up a few chords. I think positive and negative. Not from the player's point of view, but I think from the deal point of view. Now, the first thing people noticed about this was it was an 18-month deal. a few people were like, you know, why is it, you know, if he's such a good-looking player for the next few years, you know, why is this an 18-month deal? And I mentioned this in my own tweet. I think on the one hand, it's a smart move for an 18-month deal because you give him that season in League Two to show what he can do with first-team football. Because let's face it, you know. In fact, I'll even get it up myself in front of you now because we've got a hell of a lot of people out of contract in the summer, and I will probably do a full video on this. But in terms of looking at the players out of contract in Ole Gunnar's position, take away the loanees this season as well. Take away the loanees. But in terms of defenders, Tom Anderson, Cameron John, Joseph Alou, Brandon Horton. Alou's sort of going on to next January now, but you get what I mean. But Anderson, John, Horton, and Blythe. Four defenders there. Anderson, I'd probably expect to sign. Cameron John, I'd be surprised if he did sign, because I feel like he could walk into another team in League One. So for me, I'd like to see us keep Cameron John, but I wouldn't be surprised if he went. Same with Anderson, to be fair. If he wasn't injured, I wouldn't be surprised if he went, because there was the Charlton guy in one of our live streams that said the Charlton were interested, and then as soon as he got injured, bang, interest went. Blythe's a good youngster. I think he'll get loaned out again and stay on contract. And I think, again, Brandon Horton, I think he's another one that'll stay and get some game time in League Two. So that's the four defenders you'd expect to sign, or at least three out of four, if John or Anderson or both go, so two out of four at least. Ole Gunnar, for me, would get game time. I think for me, Ole Gunnar would get game time. Like I say, it feels a bit like Joe Wright. He came to the club from Huddersfield a few years back, packed with potential, realised that potential. I think he was a good player, but injuries just didn't help him at all. So I really hope this one's different, where it's less injuries that hinder the development of Ole Gunnar. So on the one hand, it's a smart move for an 18-month, because you give him that season in League Two to see what you can do, and then extend it from there. But on the other hand, an 18-month deal, the club falls into a trap again of letting them go for free. You know, letting them walk for free to a bigger club, and we're not getting any money from it. They get the benefits of it. So, and the club's got to be really smart here. And I replied to someone on Twitter, and I'm not joking. If he is a star man, gets scouted by Championship and League One clubs this time next year for the summer, and we let him walk for free to one of those clubs, I think I'm done. I think I'm done with the ownership. Because how could you let someone who potentially could be a star man in that defence next season, which is looking like it's being League Two, and you know what football's like nowadays, especially in the Championship, League One, League Two. You look at how clubs look at the lower leagues for your talent sometimes, and you look at what the money they could be prepared to pay for their talent. So if we let him go for peanuts or for free and let him walk at the end of 18 months, and he's had a fantastic season, and we don't get anything from it if he goes at the end of those 18 months, what was the point in getting him in the first place? Because you just wasted 18 months, and then we had to bring in someone else who might not be as good. So what was the point? So there's positives and there's negatives. Like I said, if he walks away for free after such a good season next season, if he has a good season next season in League Two fully, I think I'm done. I think I'm done. Because you can't let good players walk away for free. You just can't. You just can't. That's not a football mentality. That's a business mentality. So, you know, that's where I stand on that. The second thing really is, obviously, we're looking for more experienced players in this window. Why have we gone for a young and hungry player? I think, you know, the loanees are an exception, because we knew we were probably going to get a couple of young loanees with some kind of experience, Josh Martin being one of them. But for me, I think Ole Gunnar brings long-term aspects with him. But on the other hand, it's like, well, you know, we were going to get experience in this window. We were looking at experience. And it does make you wonder, you know, was Junger our third choice for centre-back? I wouldn't say Downing was our second choice, but, you know, with Downing on the list, he's gone to Rochdale. Jonjo O'Toole was on the list. He's staying at Mansfield now. So it makes you think, how far down the list was Ollie Younger? Was he one of the top options? Was he one of the top five options, top three options? As soon as his name come up, you know, McSheffrey says, let's go for him. You know, how far in the list was Ollie Younger? Yeah, you do have to question that, because if he's top two, three in the list, you have to think he's good. So, you know, I'd like to see what he does. I've had Sunderland fans message me all the time today saying, you know, that he's a decent player when he's given the opportunity, give him a chance, you know. And Sunderland fans really rating Ollie Younger, so I really hope he does pull through when he starts, hopefully this weekend. After watching highlights and seeing stats on this guy and seeing what he can do as a defender, I've got no doubts that he could be a good player for us long term, and hopefully try and steady the ship short term. I think it's a foregone conclusion. I think we're all but mathematically relegated to League Two this season. I think it's a foregone conclusion. So I think for me, I think it's just a case of what he does next season. I will pay attention to what he does this season, for the rest of this season, but my main focus will be on what he does next season in League Two and how he becomes part of a group of players that will want to try and steer us up back into League One at the first time of asking. Because that's got to be the goal next season. We're all but mathematically down this season. Next season, the goal has to be minimum automatic promotion, maximum the title in League Two. That's got to be the goal. We can't bottle a League Two title again. We can't. If any of you know, you know. But we can't bottle a League Two title again. We can't bottle first or second again. Minimum we've got to hope for is second place next season in League Two. Maximum first place. And I'm not saying that with any disrespect to the other teams, but we've got to go for it. We've got to be up there this season as the best of the best in League Two next season. If not, then there's serious problems at the club. So, for me, Ollie Younger's a good long-term signing, but we now also need to be looking at experience. In my opinion, I don't think we should be sticking just one centre-back signing. I think it should be two. You know, Alohu's not going to want to play week in, week out. You've got to think about his match fitness. Tommy Rowe's not a centre-back. He's better playing further forward. Carl Noyle can operate at centre-back as well as right-back, but you can't operate him there all the time. Because then he'll take traits from centre-back, put it into right-back, and it doesn't work. So, for me, you've got to bring in another centre-back. You've got to bring in another one. It's got to be someone experienced. It's got to be someone that knows how to get out of these situations, knows how to be a leader. Not just as a partner for Ollie Younger, but also a mentor for the likes of Younger, for Alohu, for Cameron John, for Ben Blythe. A mentor for these younger players. So, for me, you've got to bring in a second centre-back now. A serious, experienced one. So overall then, in summary, I think it's a good long-term deal. It's just a case of how we develop him now. Can we keep him clear of injuries? Can we keep him clear of constant managerial changes, having to play him in different ways and different tactics and different formations if the next managers come and go? You know, what do we do long-term after those 18 months? Do we keep him? Do we let him walk for free, which would be an utter shambles if he has a good season next season? So there's a million different things you've got to think about with this one. And then it puts us in a position of where do we go next in the transfer window. We've brought in a winger in Josh Martin, direct, attacking, did very well last night against Cambridge in the defeat. We've brought in a striker, experienced, used to know where the back of the net is. If we put him more up front rather than out wide, Mr. McSheffrey, maybe he'll find the net. And now we've brought in a centre-back who's long-term, bags of potential, and we've just got to try and manage him the best we can. So that's three positions. For me, like I said, we need another centre-back and we need a defensive midfielder. We need a proper CDM. I saw Rowe playing at CDM in the second half when we went through at the back, and I was like, seriously? Rowe's not a centre defensive midfielder? Are you kidding me? So for me, bring in a CDM. I don't give a flying one if Bostock's coming back from injury in a couple of months. Bring someone in that will compete with Bostock. You know, let's not just think of one player in a couple of positions or a few positions. Think about it. Think about the football side of things. Think about having a squad that have got multiple players in different positions when they come back that's going to compete and that's going to want to, you know, compete and battle for their spot. Because if you have a squad where no one's battling for people's spots, so you've only got one player in every position, first team senior professionals in every position that are just comfortable, they're not going to play well. Give them someone else. Give them competition to keep their place. Keep them on their toes. Keep them running. Keep them firing. Keep them scoring. Keep them physical. Keep them on their A game. Because that is what a competitive football club would do at any level. No matter whether you had £10 million or £1. Give them competition and you keep them on their toes. And not only does it improve on the pitch, it'll also bring the fans back in. And it'll give you more financial stability off the pitch. Bit of a theory there. But for me, Ole Young is a good signing, and we will see what he does. But that is going to be it for this video, guys. Make sure you do like, comment, subscribe. And for now, I'm Aaron Chandler from Furrow Football DRFC. Keep living the Riverside. That, my friends, full-time Riverside diet. Thank you very, very much. And I'll see you for the MK Dons preview on Friday. Take care.